Yeah, believe it or not, it is closely to midnight and I had like a long day today. So I want to make it short and I want to answer the question. I even forgot the question. So the question is, what math is required for business information systems? I'm a student in business information systems by myself in Germany. So I'm going to give you some deep insights into my curriculum for business mathematics so you can decide how difficult business mathematics is for you. So before the video starts, I'm gonna give you like a great tool which will definitely help you if you have difficulties in mathematics. There is like a great website and this website is for free, and no, I'm not doing advertisement for them because I get like millions of dollars to do this. And with this Khan Academy, or inside this Khan Academy, you will find hundreds of videos about several topics in mathematics. There's also like a small, let's say, forum or chat where you can ask other members if you have difficulties to solve these tasks. And the great thing about Khan Academy is that you're gonna introduce into topics you don't know. Step by step, you can solve those tasks, and at the end, you're gonna learn a lot, in my own opinion. So if you have difficulties, check this website out. So, 3-2-1, so here in Berlin, during my studies in business mathematics, so the first topic you have to face are the basics. So, what is included in the basics? You have to understand in the basics, in my own opinion, is definitely the logic, functions, and the so-called limit value of a sequence. So, logic, if you don't remember what logic is, it is like in logic you would usually use so-called truth table. We in German call it die Wahrheitstabelle. And with the Wahrheitstabelle, we can describe different conditions. So let's take a look on the functions. You know, functions are pretty easy. I think functions, it is something you already might have faced in high school. And what could be a little bit difficult is the so-called limit value of a sequence. And if you don't know why we use those limit values, so with the limit values we can describe if a function is limited, and if a function is limited, then we can say that the function is moving towards zero, and if the function isn't limited, then it's moving towards the infinity. So I would recommend you definitely to take a close look on how those so-called value of sequences or limited value of sequences are working. So on the second part is called analysis and optimization. So during my study in business information systems, I think the biggest focus in this part is definitely the so-called differential calculus, especially with the close focus on the derivation rules and definitely the rule of L'Hôpital. So you see, I can also speak a little bit French. Oui, mon ami. So I think like derivation shouldn't be like too difficult to understand. But of course, you can't expect that the tasks during your studies in business mathematics are gonna be easy like this. Of course, you have to face like more complicated numbers with more complicated rules, but if you can do the basics, I think you shouldn't have too many problems. So the second part of the analysis and optimization would be the optimization part one and the so-called integral calculus. So the third part is the so-called linear algebra. I think linear algebra is really common in mathematics. So you would definitely have to face the so-called linear systems of equation. Those linear systems are also well known, also during the high schools. You will definitely have done it several times. And especially from the aspects of a programmer in business information systems, you should definitely know on how the matrices are working. Because I can remember in the first semester, we also had to program matrices in Java. So the last part is called multivariate analysis. There you have to face partial derivatives and optimization part 2. I think partial derivatives is also something you already should know. I hope I could help you to give you a great insight on how the curriculum in business mathematics for business information systems looks like in Germany, so you can even better prepare yourself, so you can say, okay, I have problem in these or maybe in that field in mathematics, so you can improve them before the study starts, or maybe during your semester vacations or whatever. So at the end, I just want to say vielen Dank for watching. I wish you a great day. You can do this. I have done mathematics. I hope I'm gonna pass because the semester is not finished. I pray every day, so everything's gonna be great. We're gonna see this next video. Peace.